Hello, welcome to my channel, My Student Support System. In today's class, we will discuss first aid in fractures. This lecture in English, and if you want to study in Hindi, you can just click on I button and you will get the lecture in Hindi. You can visit my channel so that you can watch lectures in another subjects. So for this, we will start. Before starting about first aid in fracture, we should know what is fracture. Definition of fracture. So fracture is the medical term for a broken bone. It is defined as a break in continuity of the bone tissue. What are the causes of fractures? There are three main causes of bone fracture. Fracture may occur due to trauma to a body part, due to medical conditions, or sometime overuse injury. What are these? We will discuss them one by one. First is trauma. This includes direct force such as fall, twisting injury, sports injury, car accidents, or even fight. Indirect force such as the fracture of clavicle after falling on stretched hand, or sometimes due to strong muscular action. So this is the main cause of bone fracture. Another cause is medical conditions. It means there are certain bone disorders which may lead to fracture. This includes osteoporosis, infections, osteogenesis imperfecta, chronic steroid use, tumors that occur in the bone. Due to these disorders, bone may become weak and bone may break easily. You can see here, this is the bone density. Here it is more, but in osteoporosis density is less, so it may break easily. Another condition or cause of fracture is overuse injury. It is commonly seen in athletes, also known as stress fracture, result from repetitive motion and repetitive stress on the bones. Here you can see, this is the stress fracture or overuse fracture. Now we come to the classification of fracture. Fractures are classified into 7 types. What are these? These are simple or closed fracture, compound fracture or open fracture, complicated fracture, comminuted fracture, impacted fracture, green stick fracture, and depressed fracture. Now we will discuss about these 7 fractures one by one. First is simple fracture. When the bone is fractured, but there is no damage to the injury to tissue adjacent to the bone and skin is intact, then this type of fracture is known as simple or closed fracture. It can be transverse like this, oblique like this, and fissured like this. So this is simple or closed fracture. Now, compound or open fracture. Compound means there is combination of something. So when the fracture is associated with skin breakdown or wound formation which may lead to infection, then it is known as compound fracture or open fracture. Here you can see the bone is coming out from this bone and skin is not intact. So this is compound fracture. Then complicated fracture. When the fracture is associated with injury to vital or important organs such as brain, spinal cord, lung, liver, spleen, kidney, etc., and is associated with dislocation from a joint above or below the fracture, then it is known as complicated fracture. Another type is comminuted fracture. When the fracture results in multiple fragments of the bone, then it is known as comminuted fracture. Here in this figure, you can see here the bone is fractured and there are many fragments like this, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, in this way, this fracture is known as comminuted fracture. Next is impacted fracture. When the fractured part of bone driven into each other due to force, then it is known as impacted fracture. Means here two, the both ends of the bone, they driven into each other. So this is impacted fracture. Another fracture is green stick fracture. Green stick means, this name is given as the green stick of the wood. So when we try to break it, it breaks at one side but another side is intact. In the same way, the bones of children, they are like green stick and they break mostly like this. They are broken on one side but intact on another side. So this is known as green stick fracture. When the fracture is only at one side of the bone while other side is intact, then this is known as green stick fracture. It occurs normally in the children below 12 years of age. Then another type of fracture is depressed fracture. Depressed means this, the part is driven inside like this. So when the broken bone driven inwards, then it is known as depressed fracture. Normally it is seen in skull fractures. Now, what are the signs and symptoms of fracture? After fracture, we can patient can feel some symptoms and we can check out suggestive that there may be fracture. So what are those signs and symptoms? Number one, swelling. There will be swelling or bruising over a bony part. Then there will be tenderness or discomfort when we apply slight pressure on the affected side. Then there may be deformity of the arm or leg when there is a complete fracture. Crepitus may be felt in some cases. What is crepitus? Crepitus is special sound when the bony parts, there is friction between the bony parts, broken parts, then this sound is known as crepitus. It may be heard at some time. And inability to bear weight on the affected foot or ankle or leg. And there is loss of function in the injured area or injured limb. In open fracture, bone protruding from the skin, this can be seen. So these are signs and symptoms of fracture. Now we come to what first aid we will provide in fracture. There may be many types of fracture, but basic first aid will remain same. So what are those? First is, do not move unnecessarily. The client should not be moved from the spot until the fractured part is immobilized or unless the life is in immediate danger or medical help is arrived. Only then we should move the client. Second is, stop any bleeding. If there is bleeding, then elevate the part and apply pressure to the wound using a sterile bandage, clean cloth or clean piece of clothing or dressing. Then immobilize the injured area. How you can immobilize? By using splints. If you suspect that they have broken bone in their neck or back, help them stay as still as possible. If you suspect that they have broken a bone in their limb, then immobilize the area using splint or sling. While applying splint, we should take care that the splint should be long enough to immobilize the joint above and below the fracture and should be sufficiently firm and wide. It should be well padded so that skin injury can be prevented. If proper splints are not available, then we can use any available material such as umbrella, walking stick, broom, piece of wood or cardboard. But at least we should immobilize the fractured part. Here you can see the examples of splints. We can make splints like this. like this, we can use body part as a splint. Here, this bone is fractured and we have splinted with the another leg and improvised using wood sticks. Then another first aid, we should apply cold to the area, wrap an ice pack or bag of ice cubes in a piece of cloth and apply it to the injured area for up to 10 minutes at a time. Treat them for shock. If patient is going to in the shock, help them to get into comfortable position, encourage them to rest and reassure them. Cover them with a blanket or clothing to keep them warm and get professional help. Here we are not treating the fracture, we are providing only first aid till the medical help is coming. So we should try to get the medical help as early as possible. We can call 112 or help them to get to emergency department for professional care. The client should be transferred to the hospital as early as possible. Then first aid in special case. In special case, especially when the skull is fractured, client should not be moved as it may harm brain. Do not give anything to eat or drink and maintain in same position while transporting to the hospital. This principle is also applied while providing first aid in the fracture of cervical vertebra or fracture in the neck. If spine is fractured, then the client should be kept in spine position on flat hard surface and transported to the hospital as early as possible. So dear students, you can make your notes by visiting my student support systems blogspot.com. that is my blog. And to visit this blog, you can just write mynursingstudents.blogspot.com in the browser. For the first aid of other emergencies, please continue to watch my channel. Soon, I will come with another lectures on first aids. Thank you.